here. Just working on the Tamiya Bruiser today. Tamiya Bruiser body with what is that? Gmade chassis. Show you what I got going on today. Playing with naked dolls, obviously. But this is a 10-inch figure. Right here. So this is a good size. Good size for this truck. We'll set them up. Put them over here. Sorry about the shitty filming. But yeah, this is he's a good size. He's a 10-inch figure from Figure Toys. I can't see with my through the camera. So he's 10 inches. You know, he can reach the door handle. You know, standing next to the tires, that's probably right size. Probably right size for the shock. So he's actually scaled to the Bruiser body. And had to mock them up. Make sure we're doing some interior. I'll show you guys to cut out the windows and hoods, hood scoops, doors, whatever, needle and thread, or just thread sawed through the windshield. And I'm just mocking up the interior today. I'm probably going to carve my own figure. You know, I carve all my own figures, usually. The heads. But 10 inches for Tamiya Bruiser is probably good. Little pig I made up, of course, Hog Heaven, on the skateboard. Yeah, he's cool, man. You know, check him out. You know what I'm saying? So, and here's what we got going on inside. My puppy's playing in the background. Probably watch this here. But here's what we got. Smock up. Drying right now in place, and I just got the screws in the sides right now to hold it, just to hold it up in there. I ain't got to bolt it in. It's just sitting there freestyle, and it's sitting right on the transmission. This is what we need to do to get this guy in there. So, keep my finger. Like I said, I'm doing this on an iPad, and it has no handle on it. And if I put my hand up too high, it gets caught. So we'll go ahead and put this guy up in here. All right, and I'll show you. He fits in there really good. Turn his head around. His neck's a little loose. And we'll put this guy up. So there we go. He's in there. And he's in there. Perfect. So move his legs. Yeah, I'll put the camera down there so you can see he's sitting there all nice and comfy. That's about perfect height, and that gives me an opportunity to put my door panels in there. I'm built door panels, and so when I get these doors open and closing, you know, I'll be able to have door panels on there and get them to be on there and see if it's in a perfect 10-inch figure toys. So here's a look at the Bruiser. Yeah, she's pretty nice. I got a lot of toys. Quit looking at my toys. Quit looking at my cards, man. I got a lot of new rigs to review and go over some builds. So it's a pretty good look at it. One more in this breakfast spot. I made the exhaust come through the bumper, of course. Why not tuck it up, you know what I mean? This is not going to be a crawler. I mean, it's... I'm going to wheel it, for sure. But this is not going to be a crawler. This is going to be a trail rig, strictly trail rig. If it was going to be a crawler, I'd go with a different style of tire, but I think part of Tamiya Bruiser charm is the... are them tires, man, them Terra tires. Badass. So, but yeah, man, looks good. I really couldn't afford a Tamiya Bruiser. I like to build all my own stuff. So, oh, here comes my puppy. Her name is Dorothy. Dorothy, what are you doing, sweetie pumpkin? That's my girl. 7th generation purple ribbon. She's 14 months old. 14 months. Just a little over a year. No? Yeah. 14 months. A little over a year. So, yeah, she's looking good. She's looking good. If you have any tips about keeping the Hilux on there, every time I clean this sucker, I catch another letter and pulls off. The bigger ones are good. I mean, I've tried to polish it and get rid of all the sharp spots on it, but the emblems just, they just fall off. But yeah, man, she looks good. But the reason why we got Evil over here naked is what we're going to do. I'll show you. We're making clothes for him, and we're going to make him a cowboy. You know, of course, he's going to have his pig. He's going to, you know, he's like a show dude. He goes around the malls with his mall crawler with his little special pig. And, you know, does tricks. Kind of like the old monkey with sitting on the pig with the six-shooter cap guns in the hat. The old cats know about that. Hey. But yeah, man, I'm making a flannel shirt out of some old boxers. And I'll show you how we're going to do it. You're going to put them down the way you want the flannel shirt on them. Okay. And we'll just, you know, leave it double-aired. Never mind the dookie. No, I'm just kidding. Actually, these are new. And we'll get a piece of paper. And we'll lay that down. And we'll trace it out on paper. And then we're going to have a template. And you leave it double. And I'll show you here in a second. And how to show you how we're going to do this. Okay, here we go. This is what we do. And no, I am not, I hate to say it, but I'm not gay. And, this serious business, I take my modeling very seriously. So, what we're going to do is, you know, we just trace around them. Make sure you leave plenty of room. You know what I mean? We can trace around them. I really ain't got to show you guys tracing because I need two hands to hold the paper or whatnot. You know, make sure you give them plenty of length because you can always, you can always, I might even make him a trench coat. But just make sure you leave plenty of length. Right? Remember, this is already going to be automatically doubled when you leave it folded. Leave your cloth folded. And, you know, just make it big enough. You know, you guys get the idea. Boom, boom. Take them off. You got the general measurements. He can style it a little bit. You know, he's going to have a big collar. You know, of course, it's going to be a cowboy shirt. And we'll see when this gets folded down and the ends sewn. Because you got to, if you don't sew the ends, they'll fray. And I'll show you a little trick to that. You know, I've made clothes with using shugu. You know, you just run your bead on your cloth. You know, and then clamp it, right? With your clamps, you got some clamps. I'll show you. I got one right here. You know, to hold your fabric shut. You know, just put them all around, hold your fabric shut. Okay, and then when you turn it inside out, it'll look like it's sewn. You know, and it gives a pretty hard crease. But ain't nothing wrong with a little needle and thread, man. Every man needs to know how to sew. You know, you never know, you get it in the field and you get hurt or something like that. You need to sew yourself up or even, you know, repair something. You know, there's nothing wrong with sewing at all. Okay, so that's how we're going to do that. And I'll probably do all that off camera. You know, I'll stop in the middle and give you guys a demonstration of how I'm doing that. When I get the seats out, I'll show you how I'm doing that. So, and I'll show you how I fill it, how I'm gonna fill all the gaps, and how I'm gonna fill all the gaps and everything in there. And I'll show you how to smooth that out, and it'll look just like the back of that seat. So, you know, I'll show you how to get that all molded and modeled out real easy. I don't use Dremel tools or nothing. I do all my stuff by hand. So here's another guy I used, and just to demonstrate, you know, I made him a little bandana and a, you know, a little two bandanas on him. And I got his head connected with magnets. See what I'm saying? So, and I'll show you another character. And this is what I had on him for my Facebook followers. Had this guy, or that helmet on him. You know, he was in my monster truck, so he had his helmet on him. Had this helmet on him. But what I did, I took a Zippo container, cut it, turned it inside out, took a screwdriver, made his teeth. You know what I'm saying? I hammered it, jeweler's screwdriver through there, and made his teeth. Made his eyes, so his skeleton, and I took some of those googly eyes, and I put him on a little spring, so when he rolls, his eyes bounce, you know what I'm saying? And it's just glued in there. He's going to be a good character, and I'll show you something cool about this little dude. His eyes glow when you got to... You guys might have seen him in my buggy on Facebook, guys, seen him on my buggy. But he has a hole in the back of his head. See? So he lights up. So he's badass. But yeah, man. This guy's going to go on one of my Doom buggies. One of my racing buggies. I'll show you it. I mean, I got, you know, models for days, Jones boats. Because the Big Bear League, the parts, the medication bottles, they medication, they're full of screws, nuts and bolts. You know, so I got monster trucks and shit too. So, you know, cars, models everywhere. So, there's my big, Corsco Jeep. I'll show you that frame. It's all custom built frame. All welded, boxed in. Vintage Tamiya tank. T4. And then I got the IMX. That's a 23 pound King Tiger. FJ. SCX 10 with custom suspension, leaf spring suspension on there, my own mods. Grasshopper, I cut, took 2 inches out of that, so it's stubby. 4-link suspension, steel skid plate, original Optima. Yeah, I just got tons of them. I'll be reviewing all of them, going through all my models again, my beautiful Big Bear, you know. So, yeah, that's what we got going on. All right, man. Expect more videos from me. I think I'm going to start this YouTube thing off again, man. I've been doing Facebook for a while, but I'm just kind of fed up with all the politics on my Facebook. You know, I can't look at all my, you know, all my model channels without seeing something crazy. So I'll just do my own shit on here. All right. I'll see you guys later. Style RC. Peace out.